Namaste. Welcome to this spa place.
Hello. How are you? Good?
I'm good. Thank you. Welcome to my office. Here we have different herbs, different things. We have different body types.
Olá, tudo bem, pessoal? Hoje nós vamos conversar com o Dr. Roshan Baskota, ele que é especialista em medicina Ayurveda. Doctor, it's a pleasure to you here.
Thank you so much.
And doctor, you can tell me about your life and your job in Ayurveda.
Okay.
In the beginning, like every people, I have also started with a basic schooling, and then after a while, like in Nepal especially, it is believed if someone is a doctor, then they are very reputed. So everyone wished to be a good doctor. And then I was searched in like which would be the best topic I read so that I'm a good doctor and also I can help in many ways. And then after that, I went to the science faculty, mm-hmm. so where we read about physics, chemistry, biology. And at that time, I found one of the amazing ancient science called Ayurveda, and we had that study in Nepal. So it's under the bachelor's degree called Bachelor in Ayurvedic Medicine and Surgery. So I joined for that, and luckily I got a scholarship there, and then I was more than happy. So I started with that. And after that study, basically what we do is we go to the clinic, we use all those applications of Ayurveda, we diagnose the patient, and that's how I started my journey. But at some point I felt, okay, just treating the patient, it is not going to be all right because we can do something preventive and promotive before they are ill. And then I thought, okay, what should I do? And then now I've started working in Dwarikas as a preventive and promotive, modification of food and lifestyle and all the principles of Ayurveda I apply to the people so that there's preventive and promotive health, so that they should not be ill.
How long time the universe?
In university, we have the bachelor degree for 5.5 years. Now, 4 years is complete theory. They teach us about anatomy, physiology, microbiology, and all these things, and also from the ancient science. And after that, 1 year, we have an internship. We need to practically work under our supervisor in the hospital, where we learn the practical things.
And how long does treatment last?
Okay, it's definitely different time for different patient, different body, different disease, because every people, Ayurveda believes everyone is different.
Yes.
This is because they all are gifted with different energies, different body type. We call it three dosha body type.
Three
means three, dosha means energy. So there is a theory of three energy body type. Even they have named it Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So these energy combination makes everyone different. And the disease is the imbalance of this energy. So it depends upon how badly the imbalance is there, or it depends upon what are the food and lifestyle that the person use, and also depends upon the disease itself. So it can take maybe like 1 hour, someone can use some oil, it feels so relaxed after an hour, it can take up to 3 months or 4 months or even a year. Okay, so it's very variable,
different.
It's not.
Doctor, where did this medicine come from? Is the Indian, Nepal, where come from?
Okay, the medicines, the beautiful part in Ayurveda is it's all very natural. The science people started practicing 5,000 to 10,000 years back.
Yes.
So back that time, there was no chemical, no drugs, nothing. So what they used to do, they used to pick some different plants around them. And also in the Ayurveda, first it's a food. So what food shall we take? When shall we take? How much proportion, okay? Second is the lifestyle, when to eat, when to do exercise, when to sleep. So these things are available everywhere. And Ayurveda also believes all the plant in the universe is a medicine, mm-hmm. but we need to identify and use it in a right dose with the right way of eating as well.
Okay, doctor, what are the main herbs used? And how do they action in the body?
Okay, so there are many plants, but now till this date, most of the, even the allopathic doctor, they prefer some herbs which has been already proven with the scientific research. So if I have to name few herbs, then one I would say Shatavari. Okay, Shatavari is a Asparagus racemosus. That's a Latin name. And next is the Ashwagandha. Ashwagandha is Vidhaniya somnifera. Okay. Now, these herbs, actually, Satavari is very good for someone, especially for female, someone who has postmenopause. Okay, so postmenopause, somewhat when the menstruation stops, then there are so many hot flashes, mood swings, and every woman has to go through this. And this is so amazing herb that this helps for decreasing those signs and symptoms, and also balance the hormones. Okay. The next, ashwagandha, it's very good for the someone who takes lots of stress, who has difficulty in sleep, because most of the people today, due to the work, due to the business, it's stress. More than the physical, it's the mind, it's the emotion. And yes, that medicine actually works to that level, to the emotion, okay, to be self-strong, okay, in a way.
And how is the diagnosis made in Ayurveda? And what is the relation of the five elements for to health?
Okay.
To the health.
Wow, that's amazing.
It's five elements or four?
It's five actually in Ayurveda. So some science, some philosophy believes it's earth, water, fire, and wind. But Ayurveda believes there's also the space or sky. So five elements. How to diagnose? Definitely 10,000 years back, there was no blood test, no MRI, no CT scan, nothing. But back that time, they used to use three basic tools. They call it darshan, sparshan, prashna. Darshan, that is all in a Sanskrit. So darshan means to see, to inspect, to look, by looking. Okay, how is the hair? How is the body structure? How is the tongue? How is the eye? Just by looking. Okay. The second is the sparsha. Sparsha is the touch, by touching or palpation. And the best part is they touch the pulse. Okay. Yes. They use three fingers for three different energies, vata, pitta, and kapha. Three fingers, yeah, for vata, pitta, and kapha, and we check the pulse, and which is the body type, and which is balanced, which is not balanced, that's second. The third is the questionnaire, so we literally ask, okay, how is your sleep, how is your food, how is your energy, there are infinite number of questions. So these three basic tools, but other than that, we go with the urine, with the sweat, with the appetite, with the sleep, so we ask everything.
And where the people can practice this medicine?
To practice this medicine, someone need to, now especially in Nepal, we need to first complete this degree, 5.5 years course, and then we need to register in the council. We have an Ayurvedic council. We need to get the council certificate and a number, and after that only we can prescribe medicine, we can diagnose, and we can treat the people.
E vocês que acompanharam a nossa fanpage perceberam que aqui tem uma casa de sal e uma casa de cristal. Agora vocês vão saber os benefícios delas para a saúde. Doctor, here have one room salt and one crystal room, yeah?
Yes.
What the benefits for the health?
All these places here, all the activities in the resort is well designed, getting all the knowledge from ancient wisdom, from yoga, from meditation, and also from astrology. Now salt room, in the salt room we have a beautiful Himalayan pink salt. And this Himalayan pink salt is very, very rich in all the minerals. So we have sodium, potassium, and all the minerals. So one advantage where we go inside the salt room is our body pain. They call it arthritis. So we can have any of those arthritis, it gets better. The pain gets better when we are inside the salt room. And also salt is hygroscopic in nature. Hygroscopic means which tends to attract the water molecule. So that attracts the water molecule. Yes, we get dehydrated, but it also attracts the toxins in the joints. So what happens? The toxins makes the pain in the joints. And if that goes outside the body, then it feels much more easy movement and relax. Second, when we inhale and exhale the air, it directly goes to the lungs and back from the lungs. So this helps in a good respiratory system or good breathing system. So nose, and someone has a sinus issues or any kind of sinus or the breathing problem, it helps with that. Mm-hmm. And in general, it also helps with the body pain. Okay, so these are the advantages of salt room. But again, we need to drink more water when we are in salt room, because salt makes us dry. Our skin gets dry, our body gets dry, even eyes get dry. So drink more water. The second beautiful place is a crystal room. And this crystal room is full of the rock crystals, Himalayan rock crystals. And these crystals has amazing power. Let's say we emit some light in the crystal, crystal reflects the light or pass the light. The light has positive energy, negative energy, all kinds of energy. But when it comes out of the crystal, it's only the positive energy. And that room is all around the floor, top, all the walls, crystal. So what happens when we sit inside and relax, it's very good vibration, very good energy. And some ancient science also believes there's an aura. Aura is like energy field in our body. And it helps to cleanse that aura. Okay, so in this way, it's a wonderful place. We can do meditation, we can just relax, and it feels so good.
Doctor, here have one chakra meditation, yeah? What the benefits for the health?
Okay, now this chakra meditation is derived from the yogic science. In yoga, which is again a very ancient science, it believes there are different 7 energy points. Starting from the crown, to the third eye, to the throat, to the heart, to the stomach, to down. So there are 7 different chakras in different location. And these chakras are actually the energy wheels. So yoga believes there are different energy wheels at different parts in the body. And these energy wheels, it's spinning. But sometime, let's say some problem, some emotional problem, some food problem, some lifestyle problem, then one or the other chakra do not spin or very slowly spin or sometime even very quickly spin. Suppose one example, throat chakra. If throat chakra is spinning in a slow rate, then people cannot speak what's there in their heart. They cannot express what they have in their heart. And there is always difficulty to express the things. So now in this chakra healing chamber, we go, we meditate. There is a different sound for different chakra. There's a different color for different chakra. We go in that room with that color, that sound, so that we heal that specific chakra. Okay, if it's a heart chakra, then people are very emotional. Okay, someone says something, it hurts very quickly. Okay, if it's a digestive chakra, Manipura chakra, then it difficulty in the digestion. Mm-hmm. Okay, either constipation or diarrhea are always very difficulty. And this third eye chakra is intuition. Someone who has a good third eye chakra, they are very intuitive. Okay, they will know what's going to be happen. One way or the different way. It is not always obvious, but they will know. So in this way, chakra has that significance. And then massage also, our spa is named after Pancha Kosha Spa. Pancha Kosha. Pancha Kosha, Pancha means 5, Kosha means layer. Again, yogic science believes there are 5 layers. The first is this body, it's a physical layer. Then there is a physiology, the prana layer. Then there is a mind, the mana layer. Then there is the intellect. That's an intellect, vijnanamaya layer. And there is finally the bliss layer of bliss. Bliss is that happiness we get without any reason, just happy. Sometimes we go to nature, we say, wow, beautiful mountain. So that's a happiness, that's a bliss. So now these 5 layers are addressed when we do this spa. So this is very unique spa. Okay? And we go up to the body, to the physiology, to the mind, to the intellect, finally experiencing a bliss. And at that point, these toxins are there in the body. That is also removed. Some of the toxins of the mind, being sad, being depressed, are also removed. Some of the toxins are in the physiology, maybe less circulation. That is also solved. Some of the toxins are in the intellect. We cannot give the right decision. That is also solved. And sometimes there is something that is obstructing to be happy. So everything is right, but I cannot be happy. This is because some obstruction. Again, these all are addressed in this spa. It's called Pancha Kosha. And we can also look more about it on Pancha Kosha model. So it's one of the yogic science, yogic belief of understanding the body. And we address those components.
Yeah. Anyone make the treatment?
Now, yes, definitely. If they have some herbs around them, they can use those herbs as a home remedy. And yes, there are all these herbs. Even in Nepal, our mother, grandmother, or our parents, they feed. Like someone get the cold, they put the honey and the ginger. So these are also in Ayurveda mentioned. But somehow, the people practice this from family to family, so they don't need big Ayurveda knowledge, but still they are doing something right. So yes, in that way, anyone can prescribe or anyone can have those medicines.
And where the people can practice in the places?
Okay, now an Ayurveda doctor can one serve in the government hospitals and clinics. Second, they can have their own private hospitals and clinics. There's also the research center. So yeah, they can practice in multiple ways. And also now, the best thing is we have the medical spa. Medical spa is the place where they use all these ancient way of massage to food to lifestyle.
Like here in
yes, Dhabi. Yes, like in Dwarikas also we do a retreat kind yeah. of things, and plus that we combine all these ancient knowledge of yoga, meditation, pranayam, and also the Ayurvedic modification of lifestyle. So yes, we can use this Ayurveda in multiple ways.
Okay, and you can show me the three types. The body?
Yes.
Three mother's
yes.
body.
Yes. Oh, yes, there's a picture. I'll show you the picture, okay? So, okay, I'll show you this beautiful painting to explain about the body type. Yes. So, I said about the body type and also the five elements. I'll explain at the same time. So, three body types, Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. Vata is that body type which is like wind and the sky. So like wind and the sky, which is very quick, dry, sky is light, so very lean and thin body, here very dry and rough, skin also dry and rough. These are the Vata dominant energy.
Vata?
Vata, dominant. Yes, dominant, more Vata.
Yeah.
And the second is a Pitta. Pitta means a fire like, so fire, very sharp body, average body built, maybe muscular, easy to lose weight, easy to gain weight. Having a sharp mind, organized, logical, critical, that's a fire dominant person. And third, this beautiful calm earth and water, which is called Kapha. So looks skin also very thick, moist, hair also thick and moist. Everything does slowly, calm, loyal, forgiving, grounded. So these are the three different body types. And we are a combination of one or the other. And
me?
Someone is a dominant. Now, I need to check your pulse. Let me check your pulse, okay? So we use Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. Okay, so your dosha deep inside your prakriti is a fire and the wind, but there is a fire that is dominant. So you are a person who is like a fire, so sharp mind, logical, critical, okay, and nothing out of balance. But if fire gets out of balance, let's say you didn't take food at the right time, you take lots of spicy food, then that sharp mind turns into sharp tongue. Intelligent mind into anxious, okay?
Yes.
Who has a good sense of judgment turns into very judgmental to others. Organized into over perfectionist, okay? So these are the different body types and the balance and the imbalance. Balance means healthy, imbalance means sick. Balance means physically, emotionally healthy. Imbalance means either physically or emotionally or both unhealthy, okay?
Okay.
So it's about balance and imbalance. And we use this food and lifestyle to balance or imbalance.
Doctor, thank you very much for your interview with us. E é isso aí, gente. Nós só temos a agradecer ao Dr. Ocean por nos dar essa explicação sobre a medicina da Ayurveda e nos lembrar o quão importante é ter uma vida balanceada, com bons fluidos e o contato equilibrado com a natureza. Muito obrigado e namastê!